Alrighty guys, so before you get into today's video, I just want to say I'm speaking from as if these text messages are real. I don't know if these text messages were real or not. I don't know who's right in this situation. So I don't want you guys to go in the comment section and say, oh, he's defending AB, he's defending Bruce Arians. I'm just reporting the news as I see it and as I get it. Again, we don't know who is right in this situation. I'm just reporting the news.
Wow. So YouTube, what's going on? It's Juan Gotti here with yet another NFL video. And in today's video, we have some breaking news coming out of Tampa Bay. So we already know what's been going on with the whole Antonio Brown situation and the Bruce Arians situation. So if to catch you up to speed, if you're not up to date on the whole situation, so the Tampa Bay Buccaneers had a game versus the New York Jets, and to where Antonio Brown kind of got triggered on the sideline. He removed all of his uniform, you know, equipment, and he went streaking into the end zone and basically quit and left the game. He was spotted getting an Uber, you know, leaving the stadium with a police escort, and everything was going on, and people automatically assumed and went to saying, oh, he's crazy, he needs help, I don't know what's wrong with Antonio Brown, and no one really thought to say, what caused this? There is always three sides to a story with everything, whether it's, you know, NFL, sports, or just life in general. It's always three sides to a story. The one person's side, the other person's side, and the truth. So Antonio Brown, he basically went out and released a statement basically saying, I'm not going to read the whole thing, I'm just going to sum it up here, basically saying that he told Bruce Arians that he wasn't healthy. You know, Antonio Brown has been dealing with that nagging ankle injury all season long. That's why he missed 8 weeks with that, and then he got suspended. And he just, they are apparently, they knew that he wasn't 100%. And Bruce Arians still tried to force him to play, and Antonio Brown wasn't rocking. They were trying to force him to go into the game. Antonio Brown said, coach, I'm not healthy enough to go into the game. And they basically kicked him off the team because he didn't want to play. And again, if this is true, what's coming out now, this is not a good look for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers at all. Because again, this is a team that's led by one of the greatest NFL players of all time, if not the greatest NFL players of all time, in Tom Brady. This is a team that was supposed to possibly make another run at a Super Bowl, and now all of this is coming out. This can be detrimental, not just to their football team, but just the corporation and the franchise as a whole. Now, today, we got some more breaking news, because if you guys read what Antonio Brown said in his statement, he basically told Bruce Arians that he was hurt, he wasn't feeling well enough to play, and Bruce Arians came out and basically denied that and said in his presser that he didn't know Antonio Brown was injured. Oh really, BA? I don't know if that's the truth or not. So I have the text messages here from Antonio Brown. Now, of course, I had to make sure this wasn't, you know, Photoshopped or anything. It looks pretty legit. So let's read these comments or this text message conversation between Bruce Arians and Antonio Brown. So Bruce Arians says, this is BA. Make sure you're ready to go tomorrow. We're not resting for the playoffs. Then he said, call me. And apparently Antonio Brown sent the picture of him getting treatment on his ankle. And this was Antonio Brown's reply. I'm all in, coach. Really can't go get to full speed. I want to win. I want to be there. If I wake up tomorrow feeling better, I'll be ready. Kind of rolled it outside on the two-point play. I want what's best for the team. Let me know when you're free. I'll call you. Then BA Bruce Arians responds, come see me in the morning. We'll talk it out. Definitely want you with us in case you're ready. So if this is in fact true of what Antonio Brown leaked of their conversation, this puts all of the Bruce Arians not knowing that Antonio Brown wasn't healthy out the window. You know what I'm saying? And again, this wouldn't be a good look for Bruce Arians and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. So again, I just wanted to bring this to you guys' attention that you can't just always run with what the first thing you see, right? Because again, the quick narrative was to say, oh, he's suffering from CTE. He's crazy. He doesn't know what he's doing. Again, Antonio Brown, if he has CTE or not, he's just not going to act out just randomly, right? It's going to be something that has to trigger that, and obviously this was. And I feel like a lot of people out there thought he was just acting crazy, just to act crazy. You know what I'm saying? No, that's not the case. If this is in fact true, this is a huge reason that this is why he was acting that way, and he felt like he was getting treated poorly by the coaching staff. And again, this isn't a good look for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Someone was actually kind enough to put some, you know, timelines of where Bruce Arians was typically being unfair to his players. So number one, Bruce sent Gronk back into the game with broken ribs, had Godwin running sprints on the sideline with a torn ACL, had Fournette running routes after his injury led to IR, had Tom Brady play on an unreported MCL tear, Winston playing with a torn meniscus and fractured thumb. So this isn't new, apparently, with Bruce Arians. He's always had a track record, you know, of which making his players play on injuries. So again, man, it's not looking too good for Tampa Bay. Let me know what you guys think about this whole situation in the comment section down below, and stay tuned for more things coming out about this, because this won't be the last time we talk about this situation. So now, moving on to my Washington segment of today's video. So we got some news today, guys. Obviously, we know Charles Leno got his extension yesterday. Congrats to Charles Leno. But today, during a press conference, Jack Del Rio was asked how did he feel about his future and what does he think his future withholds with the Washington football team as the defensive coordinator. And Jack Del Rio basically said, I will be here. They asked him, does he think he's going to be here? Is there any uncertainty about that? And he said, there's no uncertainty. I will be here. And you know what I say to that? At first, I was like, oh, he's testing Ron, you know what I'm saying? Just joking around, you know? But again, Jack Del Rio coming back, not a surprise. This isn't the issue that I had. My issue is with the positional callers, or the positional coaches, rather, and Scott Turner. Those are my two main problems. I didn't have an issue with JDR. I know JDR wasn't the best this year. I did feel like he wasn't as aggressive as he was in 2020, but I felt like JDR wasn't that big of a problem like everyone was always making it out to be. I think these positional coaches are more, not really necessarily more important, but they have closer relationships with these players. So these players are going to do what their positional coaches are coaching them to do. You see what I'm saying? So again, I don't have a problem with JDR being back. I totally expected him to be back. I don't expect anything to be changed, actually. I really hope we take a deep dive into these positional coaches. I already made a video on this, so I'm not going to harp on it too long. And I really want to take a look at Scott Turner. I'm not saying move on from Scott Turner 100%, but I'm just saying at least see where his head at and see what other candidates you have out there that could possibly be better. So man, let me know what you guys think about this down below in the comment section. How do you feel about Jack Del Rio basically saying, I will be here next year? There is no ifs, ands, or buts about it. It would be funny if Ron says, oh really, huh? You think you're going to be here for sure? You ain't tell me about that. You're fired. Imagine he did. That would be so funny. But no, I'm joking. Ron isn't that kind of guy, and I'm sure Ron has already, you know, told him, you're back. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just joking around. Again, I wanted JDR back. I felt like he isn't the main problem. It's the positional coaches. So we'll see. He talked about him seeing Chase Young and how they've been missing his presence and how it will be a lot of changes made this offseason and a lot of looking at this whole team this offseason. So guys, buckle in, man. The offseason has officially started for the Washington football team, although we still have one game left. Let me know what you guys think about this whole video, Antonio Brown situation, and our Washington football team's defensive coordinator, Jack Del Rio, guaranteeing that he will be back in 2022. As always, been Bill Juan Gotti. Like, comment, subscribe. Hail to the Washington football team. Subscribe if you want more NFL content. I'm out. Peace.